Hey, thanks for tuning in. My name is Neil. I'm the technician that runs Grimco's demo center here in our Chicago facility. So behind me, I have the HP 800 series. This is HP's latest printer out on the market. There's the 700 and 800 series. And one of the coolest features about this new machine is that it has the ability to print with white. You can order either one of the models, the 700 or the 800 series, with the white option. So I want to take you through a quick video this morning and show you how to load up the white printheads into the machine. The coolest feature about this new HP latex is when you're not using the white ink, you remove the printheads from the printhead carriage. They're stored down in the chamber, so it's a true on-demand white. I haven't printed white on this machine in a couple days now. I haven't purged a single drop of white ink to keep my system fresh, and I want to show you how HP achieves this amazing result. White ink has traditionally been a difficult ink to work with because it has to constantly be circulated or purged to keep that ink from drying out or coagulating inside the machine. HP solved this issue by utilizing their user replaceable printheads. So when I'm not printing with white ink, I remove those printheads from the printhead carriage, store them down inside their container, and when I need to print with white, it's a simple matter of reinserting those printheads, and then I'm ready to print with white ink. So first things first, I'm going to initiate the printhead replacement from the front panel of the machine. This is going to prepare the system as well as rotate the chamber that my printheads are currently being stored in. And now I'm going to follow the instructions on the front panel of the machine to complete this process. So first things first, I'm going to remove the rotating chamber. And this is where my printheads are stored when they're not inserted in the printhead carriage. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and raise the carriage cover. And that exposes my printhead carriage. Now at this point, I unlatch the printhead carriage cover and I'm going to remove my auxiliary printheads. I've went ahead and labeled my printheads, printhead one and printhead two, so that when I put in my actual printheads, I can keep them straight. The auxiliary printhead doesn't have any nozzles. It just caps off the entire system. And this is what allows the machine to circulate the ink supply without having to purge ink in the process. By keeping printhead one and printhead two always in the same location, it's going to reduce the amount of times that I need to do a printhead alignment with my white ink. I'm going to go ahead and close the cover back up. Now at this point, I would close my printhead carriage cover and let the machine go through its check and clean process. I'm going to install a little stopper here so we can leave this open and see what the machine's doing during this process. Right off the bat, it's asking me to reinsert this into the offline rotating chamber. And now it's going to go through the check and clean process to make sure the printheads are firing correctly. And so there you're seeing the maintenance cartridge that keeps the printheads nice and clean. One of the benefits of HP Latex ink is a water-based system, so it's a very stable ink formula to work with. This machine's perfectly happy sitting, not printing. You don't really have a worry of the inks drying out in the process because it is a water-based system that until it goes through that high heat curing process is very stable and happy to sit there. One of the unique things HP did with this maintenance cartridge for the white ink print system is the part of the maintenance cartridge that cleans the white print heads uses a little bit of distilled water. You can see it spraying out on that cleaning cartridge right now. White ink, because it is a trickier ink system, needs a little bit of help on that maintenance wiper roll to decap or clean off the crust, wipe the underside of those print heads and get it printing nice and clean.
So at this point, the machine's going through its automatic drop detection. It's firing a little bit of ink from the nozzles and the white print heads, making sure there's a sufficient amount of nozzles firing. If it notices there's a problem, it will tell me, hey, there's a potential printhead issue. At that point, I can go through additional cleanings to recover those nozzles, or I can decide, hey, this printhead has reached its eventual end of life. It's time for a fresh one. At that point, simple matter of pulling out the old one, dropping a new one, a printhead alignment, and then I'm back up and printing within minutes. That's the benefit of the HP Latex user replaceable printheads. There's zero downtime with your machine, so long as you have the printheads on hand. Okay, the machine's all finished with the process. I went ahead and closed my cover, and I'm ready to start printing with that true non-yellowing HP Latex white ink. If you want some more information about these machines or would like to see some samples, please shoot an email to hplatex@grimco.com. I'm going to go ahead and get back to it because these decals aren't going to print themselves. Thanks for watching the video.